Today, we're going to be comparing YSL Y Eau de Parfum and also Dylan Bleu. So if you're interested in the comparison of these two, which one is better, which one is more worth the money, which one gets more compliments, then definitely keep on watching. 3, 2, 1, let's do this. My name is Monica Chauhan. On this channel, we talk about fragrances, colognes, anything to do with scent. So if you are interested in such topics, then definitely subscribe and press the notification bell to get notified of when I post, because sometimes YouTube won't show you my videos otherwise. But let's get on to the video. So I've got two blue fragrances. They are considered blue because they're made to be quite versatile. They're kind of woody, spicy, aquatic, that sort of scent that is very versatile. Both of these are versatile. They are perfect for every day. If you are looking for an everyday fragrance that everybody will like, these two are constructed to be that way. But which one is better? So the packaging for me is definitely better on Y. It's just sturdier. I like the bevels and stuff on the cup of the Y. I think the bottle is much more sophisticated. Versace, it's a simple bottle. It kind of feels a bit cheap. So I would say here, YSL wins. I would give it a 9 out of 10, and for Dylan Bleu, a 7 out of 10. Now, the scent. Let's start with Dylan Bleu. I have sprayed it on my arm, and I must say that for me, this is a super manly scent. So if you are interested in a super manly, versatile scent, this one would be for you. I get loads of grapefruit. I think there's also like fig leaf in there. So it kind of smells a bit green, a bit aquatic, woody, spicy. It also kind of weirdly reminds me of an aroma of sweat. It is somewhat pleasant, but also I get this, yeah, the sweat thing. It's not quite like a natural sweat. It is a sweat sort of odor that you get when you are really, really sweaty, like after a workout or something. So I think it might be the grapefruit a bit, or like the greeniness of this fragrance. It kind of smells odd, but it still smells great. I'm just noting that scent because to me as a woman, it kind of can smell a bit like sweat. So it is a very blue, aquatic, woody, warm but fresh fragrance, and I quite like it. I think it's very manly, very straight to the point. It also kind of smells a bit like Bleu de Chanel, but less sophisticated. To me, it also has some other blue fragrances just thrown in there, like maybe Sauvage, maybe a bit of Y. It has got that sort of vibe, but it's not quite as good as Bleu de Chanel or Sauvage. It just is a bit of a lot of those blue designer fragrances, but it doesn't do the job quite as well as those. I would give it a 6 out of 10 for me personally, because if I smelled this on somebody, I would say, oh, this guy is wearing a fragrance. Nice that he's wearing a fragrance, but I don't love it. It's just like, oh, he takes care of himself, and that is that. Let's look at Y, and this is Eau de Parfum version. This fragrance has got ginger and apple opening. It's a woody fragrance. It's got an amazing zingy freshness. It's amazing. I love it. As a woman, to me, this is like if a guy walked into a room wearing this fragrance, I would say, yes, this guy is wearing fragrance, and I love this fragrance. I would give him a compliment on that fragrance. It is just juicy, fresh, sweet, Just an amazing all-rounder, versatile fragrance that will get you compliments. This in terms of scent, I would give it a 9.25 out of 10. This is a scent that has got all those blue qualities of blue fragrances, but it's also a perfect standalone scent. It can be itself. It's unique enough to be like, okay, this is why. This is not Bleu de Chanel. This is not Sauvage. This is why. So it's not trying to be too much like the other ones. It is still a blue fragrance that is versatile, but it is good enough on its own and it has its own identity. That's why I love this one so much. So who would I imagine these two on? I think for Dylan Blue, I think this is a great starter fragrance. I think anybody like a teenager, somebody in college or uni, they could just buy this and wear it all the time and smell good enough so that it's like, oh, you smell really nice, but I don't think it would get too many compliments, especially now because it's known so much. So, but it's still a good fragrance. So I would say if you don't have enough money to spend on, like, you know, Bleu de Chanel or other fragrances, it's still a good fragrance and you can still get it and smell good. YSLY, I would see it on a guy that is great smelling. It could be a younger guy, it could be a uni guy, it could be a working professional, it could be an older guy, like even in his 70s. It is a versatile fragrance and I think it's quite grown up in that sense that anybody could wear it really and not be, you know, a smelling too much like a youngster. Whereas Dylan Blue, I think you just smell like a younger guy. This one is much more versatile in terms of age. For projection, YSLY is amazing. It projects like crazy. It's very, very strong. It's not like a meter. It's more like 2 meters of a scent bubble that you'll have around you. So I would say 10 out of 10 for a scent bubble. For Dylan Blue, at least on my skin, it sits very close to my skin. So I would give it about a 6 out of 10 for that. And longevity, again, YSLY, it's 8 hours plus. It's a very long lasting fragrance. So 10 out of 10 for me personally for this one. And Dylan Blue, it depends. I've heard people say that, some people say that it lasts a long time. Not on me, it's more like 6 hours around that point. So I would give it an 8 out of 10. I would say that YSLY will get you much more compliments, not only because of the scent, but because it's a newer release. It's less known, so I feel like more people will be like, oh, what are you wearing? Because I see everybody wearing the same old, and this one is a bit newer. It will get you just not only compliments, but also attention, I feel like. So this one is a great attention grabber. With this one, I feel like you might get attention for good reasons, like, oh, like my dad used to wear it, or my boyfriend used to wear it, my ex-boyfriend, or you might get those sort of, oh, somebody used to wear it and I know it. So you might get good attention from this one too, just for different reasons, I feel like. And this will get you compliments too, but not as many as this guy here. So if you are after compliments, then I would say Y is a better bet for you. YSLY, I think it's a clear winner in this battle. It is just a better overall blue fragrance. Let me know if you guys agree or if you completely disagree. Let me know why you think Dylan Blue is a better fragrance out of these two. And remember to subscribe, like this video if you like those comparison videos. If you have other fragrances that you would like me to compare, definitely drop them down in the comment box. And I'll see you all again very, very soon. Bye, guys.